this PCB is a little inaccurate in terms of size. That's because I want to keep the PCB design process very simple and use useful tools within KiCad. But in this video and also in the upcoming videos, we'll try to understand more advanced features and tools KiCad has to offer and try to make custom symbols and footprints, along with which we'll also learn how to optimize the PCB for cost-effective production. Luckily for this circuit, we got all the symbols and everything looks damn good. But there are situations we might not have the proper symbols for the components. For example, if I search for the ESP32 module on the schematic editor, I can see some ESP32s, but these are just the metal cap ICs and not the modules as a whole that is used for prototyping. In this case, we might have to create a custom symbol, or we can search for the symbol online, because there is always a high probability that someone might have either already requested for a similar symbol, or they would have made a custom symbol and published it online. I would always prefer to make a custom symbol because it will reduce the unknown variables that are introduced to the circuit. But once you find a reliable source to get your symbol and footprints, it will reduce a ton of work down the road. Fortunately or unfortunately for this particular circuit, we might not need to create custom symbols. So we'll try to recreate one of the existing symbols to learn how to use the symbol editor and learn how to make custom symbols. We'll try to do this 80 tiny IC symbol while following the library convention provided by KiCad. I'll be heavily relying on these guidelines to build the symbols, even though it's not a requirement, because following this process will make it a lot easier to maintain a large amount of custom libraries, which we'll discuss further in the future videos. Now to start, we can either use the icon on the toolbar, or we can just go to KiCad's project page and click on the symbol editor. Here in the symbol editor, the navigation is pretty simple. We have the scroll to zoom in and zoom out, and middle click and drag to pan. Not just the navigation, most of the tools are also very familiar to what we saw in the schematic editor. On the left, we have the list of libraries arranged in alphabetical order which already exist within KiCad. We can create a custom symbol and store it within any of these libraries, or we can modify an existing symbol. But let's try not to mess the default libraries and symbols. Instead, let's start with creating a new custom library. To do that, go to File, click on New Library. In this pop-up, we can either select whether this library should be available on every single project that we are going to make, or we just need this library to be on this particular project. This really depends on how often you're planning to use the custom components. If you just need it for this project, select the project option. But if you need these symbols on other projects as well, select Global. After the selection, click on OK. Now KiCad will ask the location where you want to save the library. If it's related to the project, I would suggest to save it in the same location as your project file. If not, create a folder in the desired location just for KiCad libraries and store under it. While naming, just don't name the library as My Library or Custom Library. It can get really confusing once we start to make more of these. So try to give some thoughtful names, or the better option would be to follow the library convention provided by KiCad, according to which I'll name this library as MCU_microchip_8085. Then click on save. You can see we have the custom created library here. I have to slightly modify the name so that it does not conflict with the already existing libraries. Since we have the library set up, we can create the custom symbol under this library. Make sure the library is selected and click on Create New Symbol. This will create a pop-up where we can enter the symbol details, starting with the symbol name. If you check the KiCad's library convention, it will recommend us to use the manufacturer's part number. So I'll do the same. I'll just type 80tiny85-20MU. Next, select one unit. That's because KiCad lets us create multiple units for the same symbol. For example, let's say if I want to create a symbol for Arduino, I can break down the full module into three parts, where I can group the analog pins, digital pins, and power pins as three different units. But this is a pretty simple circuit, so we'll just stick on to one. And I would suggest keeping rest of the settings to default. If you'd like to know more about these features, you can read more about them on the KiCad's library convention document page. Here we can see KiCad created the symbol with only the designator, the letter U. First, let's set up the grid settings. In the previous videos, I did not explain much about the grid sizes. But to make a good custom library, try to keep the grid value to 1.27 or 50 mils. Because as per KiCad standard library convention, all the pins should be 50 mils apart. By setting the grids to these values will make our jobs a lot easier when arranging the pins around the symbol. Now with this grid setting, first let's start with creating an outline for our symbol. I'll use this rectangle tool and create the outline. Then use the keyboard shortcut E to edit the rectangle and click on fill with body background color and then click on OK. Currently the dimension is a little random, but we can always adjust that later when we do more customization. Anyway, now let's add a few pins to this symbol using the add pin tool. And for now, forget all the settings, I'll just give the pin number as 1 and then click on OK. By the way, it's the same shortcut to rotate the letter R and to move letter M. And once you're satisfied with the position, just do a left click. Now we'll try to follow the convention while adding the pins to the symbol, where the power pins are at the top, the ground at the bottom, input or control pins on the left, output and driver pins on the right, and finally arrange all the GPIO pins or the ports in the numerical order. If you follow the rules for this symbol, we'll have one pin on the top, one pin on the bottom, and the rest on the right of the symbol. Currently, all the pins have the same name and same property. To change this, you can either select the pin and do a right click and then click on properties, or you can use the shortcut letter E. Here, we'll start with the pin name. I'll name this VCC, and according to the data sheet, this pin corresponds to pin number 8 on the physical IC. Now for the electrical type, power input, then graphical style to default. Again, if you like to know more about the rest of the settings, you can always refer to the library convention document. But for now, I'll leave everything to default and then just click on OK. So we can follow the same process to do this for each and every pin. Once the pin setup is done, we'll use this anchor tool to make the origin to the center of the symbol. Now our symbol is ready. We can either save it by using the Ctrl S command, or we can just click on this icon over here, which will save the file automatically and also will add it to our current project. We can quickly check that by going to the schematic editor. Click on Preference and then click on Manage Symbol Libraries. Since we opted this library to be only on this project, click on Project Specific Library. And here we can see we have the library that we made. If you like to include this in every single project, we can do that by going to Global Libraries and adding it over here. Since we are anyway in the Library Manager, I'll also show you how we can add external libraries to KiCad. There are a lot of good places to search for open source symbols. But I would recommend using SNAP EDA or OCTO part. They have pretty good UI and it's pretty easy to search for the part that you're looking for. And also support multiple design platforms other than KiCad. For now, let me just show you how we can add from SNAP EDA. Just go to snapeda.com and search for the part that we need. In this case, let's try searching for the part name 80985. Once you find the part, just click on download both symbol and footprint. Here you can see we have multiple options. Since we are working with KiCad, just select KiCad. Then click on version 6 and later. Once the file is downloaded, we can uncompress the file to get the symbol and the footprint. Now to add this to KiCad, go to KiCad Library Manager. As an example, I'll show you how to add this external library to your global library so you can use in every single project. Click on this folder icon, then select the symbol file that we just downloaded, which will have the extension KiCad_SYM. Then click on Open. This will add the folder to the global library. Now we can confirm this by going back to the schematic editor. Now if I search for EDATiny85, we have two new options, that is one from the SNAP EDA, that is EDATiny85-20PU, and another one that's custom created by us, that is EDATiny85-20MU. You can see we have both the custom libraries, the one we created and the other from the SNAP EDA. And this is how you make custom symbol for your schematics. In the next video, we'll see how we can make custom footprints using similar methods and also trying to keep up with KiCad's library convention. Until then, if you have any questions or doubts, you can always reach out to us at PCBCupid Q&A. If the video was helpful, like and subscribe to the channel and also share it with people who might love this kind of content. Until then, keep learning and keep creating.